In today's tutorial, I will show you how to create these animated chains in Cinema 4D. Let's begin. For this tutorial, I will use this 3D model. And I want to connect the chains to these rings. So first, I'm going to hide my main model to only see the rings. Now that I have the rings isolated, I need to create a spline path. So I'll head over to my side view to get a better angle. I want the chains to have a curve, so I'm going to create a custom spline path. So let's go and select the spline pen tool. And I'm going to click and drag here. And then here. And finally, over here. I'll adjust the curves to my liking. And once I do, I'll press the escape key so that I can complete my spline path. Let me adjust the curve a bit more. Okay, this is good. I will now go to my front view and move my spline path to the left and place it in position. I'll rotate it a bit. This looks good. Okay. I'm going back to my perspective view. And now it's time to create the chain. I will go and create a rectangle spline. Change the width to 44 and the height to 26. I will activate the rounding box to have the curved edges and change the radius to 12. Now go ahead and create a circle spline and change its radius to 5. This looks good. Now we need to generate a sweep. Head over to the extrude icon, select sweep, drag both of your rectangle and circle splines into the sweep layer. Now that we have this ready, let's clone it. Go and select your cloner. And we are going to drag our sweep layer into the cloner layer. Perfect. Now that we have this, we are going to change a few settings. Go ahead and select your cloner layer. Under mode, we are going to change that to object. And where it says object, we are going to drag in the spline path we created earlier. You will see that our chain now follows the path we created earlier. Okay, we are not done yet. In your cloner attributes, head over to the transform tab. And we are going to increase the value to 90 for the rotation H and rotation P. This is looking much better. Now let us fix the spacing. Head over to the Object tab, and where it says Distribution, change that to Even. You can see our chain is now evenly spaced. However, it seems I need to increase the number of chains. Head over to where it says Count and change that to 16. This looks good. Now, I will need to adjust the position of the chains to fit in the rings. I will select my spline path layer and then enter point mode and select the endpoint of my spline path and move them till it's in the ring, but not touching it. The same I'll do for the other end. Okay, that looks good. Now it's time to twist our chain. So select your cloner layer, and under transform, go and change the values to rotation B, and, well, this is not what I wanted. It appears if I want to twist my chains, I will need an effector. So go ahead and select your cloner layer again, and go to MoGraph, under effector, go and select step. Now go ahead and select the parameter tab and then check the scale, since that's not what we want. We want to twist our chains, so we will select rotation. And here we are going to change the values to rotation P, and you will see that this works. Now there is a formula to get the perfect rotations, and that is, you add the number of chains we have, which is 16, and multiply that by the angle we want. I want 90 degrees, and then press enter. And there you go, it perfectly twisted my chain. Now here's the important part. Make sure your chains are not touching one another. So go ahead and double check. If they do touch, then adjust it so that they don't. Once you are ready, we are now going to add some simulation tags to add some physics to our chain. We will start with our cloner. Go and select the cloner layer. Do a right mouse click. Go to simulation tags and select rigid body. Perfect. Now go and select your ring layer and do a right mouse click. Under simulation tags, go and select collider body. Now let's preview our simulation. And, well, this is bad. That's because we need to tweak some settings to our rigid body. Go ahead and select the rigid body that's in the cloner layer. And where it says shape, change that to moving mesh. Now, when we preview it, well, my computer is kind of slow. But you can see that the chains now hold to each other. Well, kind of. No problem, we can fix that. Head over to the mask tab, and where it says custom center, go ahead and activate this box. Now, when we preview it, the chains hold to each other and not break. Okay, now it's time to do that to the other side. I'll hide this here, and I'll duplicate my cloner layer by holding the control key and click and drag upward. Perfect. The same I'll do for my spline path layer. Perfect. Now that I have duplicates, I will select my cloner one layer. And where it says object, I will replace the spline with the duplicate version I made. So now my cloner one layer has the spline one path layer. All I have to do now is move my spline one path to the other side. I'll change to the front view to better guide me. Perfect. I'll head back to the perspective view and make sure that the chains is not touching the rings. Okay, this looks good. Now, I'll bring back my 3D model. And when I preview it, well, it's very slow. So I'm going to have to create a cache preview. I'll head over to my rigid body tag. It can be either one. And under the cache tab, I'll select bake all. Perfect. Now I'll preview it again. Okay, it looks good. There might need some tweaking on the left chain, but for this tutorial, it's good enough. Now, what if I want to animate my model? Will my chains follow it? Well, let's find out. I'll select my 3D model, and I'll make sure my 3D model is the parent of my rings. I'll add a keyframe at the beginning. Then around here, I want the model to move forward. So I'll add another keyframe. And finally, at the end, I want the model to move back. And I'll add another keyframe. I'll clear my cache preview by selecting Clear All Caches. And then select Bake All again. Now let's preview it. And there you have it. You now know how to create and animate chains inside of Cinema 4D. If you would like to download this project file, head over to Tuto's Gumroad page. You can find the link in the description of this video. If you found this video useful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Till the next one.